हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस DYBA कंपलसरी इंग्लिश। बिफोर दैट प्लीज लाइक सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड शेयर द वीडियो विथ योर फ्रेंड्स। द सिलेबस ऑफ द प्रोज सेक्शन इज अंकल पॉजर हैंग्स अ पिक्चर, हाउ वेल्थ अक्यूमुलेट्स एंड मेन डीके, अ रिट्राइव्ड रिफॉर्मेशन, हाउ मच लैंड डज अ मैन नीड, ऑन द रूल ऑफ द रोड, The Pleasure of Ignorance, The Selfish Giant, The Diamond Necklace. Let's move to the questions. Question number 1. Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture is a sad story, war story, horror story, humorous story. And the correct answer is option D, humorous story. Question number 2. Who helped the injured Uncle Podger in hanging the picture a second time? And the correct answer is option A, the whole family. Question number 3. The story Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture is taken from, and the correct answer is option A, chapter 3 of Three Men in a Boat. Question number 4. What did Uncle Podger ask Will to do for him? And the correct answer is option C, to get hammer. Question number 5. What is the meaning of commotion in Uncle Podger Hangs a Picture? And the correct answer is option A, noisy disturbance. Question number 6. Whom did Uncle Podger send to tell the size of nails? And the correct answer is option C, one of the boys. Question number 7. Which tools mentioned in the story for hanging the picture? And the options are nails and hammer, picture cord, stepladder and kitchen chair, all of the above. And the correct answer is option D, all of the above. Question number 8. Who have replaced men according to Shaw in How Wealth Accumulates and Men Decay? And the correct option is option C, machines. Question number 9. What an unmarried woman is called in the essay How Wealth Accumulates and Men Decay? And the correct option is option D, spinster. Question number 10. Which thinker's name is mentioned in the essay How Wealth Accumulates and Men Decay? And the options are John Ruskin, William Morris, O. Henry, both A and B. And the correct answer is option D, both A and B, John Ruskin and William Morris. Question number 11. What did the essay How Wealth Accumulates and Men Decay argue? And the correct answer is option A, the negative effects of the capitalism. Question number 12. When did J.B. Shaw die? And the correct answer is option C, in 1950. Question number 13. Who is the writer of A Retrieved Reformation? And the correct answer is option B, O. Henry. What is the real name of O. Henry? And the options are William Sidney Porter, Thomas Hardy, Ruskin Bond, Mark Twain. And the correct answer is option A, William Sidney Porter. Question number 15. When was G.B. Shaw awarded Nobel Prize? And the correct answer is option A, in 1925. Question number 16. To whom G.B. Shaw gave prize money? And the correct answer is option B, to translate Swedish literature into English. Question number 17. What was Jimmy's prisoner number in A Retrieved Reformation? And the correct answer is option A, 9763. Question number 18.
Who gave the cigar to Jimmy? And the correct answer is option C, the warden. Question number 19. How much of his imprisonment did Jimmy serve? And the correct answer is option C, 10 months. Question number 20. Who has signed Jimmy's pardon? And the correct answer is option A, the governor. Question number 21. How much does Jimmy give to the blind man at the station? And the correct answer is option A, a quarter. Question number 22. What was on the floor of Jimmy's room? And the correct answer is option B, Ben Price's collar button. Question number 23. Who is the protagonist of the story A Retrieved Reformation? And the correct option is option A, Jimmy Valentine. Question number 24. Jimmy and Ralph are one and the same person. And the correct answer is option A, yes. Question number 25. The story, How Much Land Does a Man Need, is written by, and the options are William Shakespeare, John Milton, Thomas Hardy, Leo Tolstoy. And the correct answer is option D, Leo Tolstoy. Question number 26. Who prefers the peasant life? And the options are Pahom's wife, his sister-in-law, Pahom, none of these. And the correct answer is option A, Pahom's wife. Question number 27. How many sisters are referred in the story, How Much Land Does a Man Need? And the correct answer is option A, two sisters. Question number 28. Who is the protagonist of the story, How Much Land Does a Man Need? And the correct option is option D, Pahom. Question number 29. What was Pahom's main flaw in How Much Land Does a Man Need? And the correct option is option A, his greed. Question number 30. Who was ungrateful for the life in How Much Land Does a Man Need? And the correct answer is option C, Pahom. Question number 31. Who is the writer of On the Rule of the Road? And the correct answer is option D, A. G. Gardner. Question number 32. In the essay On the Rule of the Road, the writer speaks about, the correct option is option A, liberty and individual freedom. Question number 33. What is the meaning of rule of the road? And the correct answer is option C, preserve the liberties to all. Question number 34. The essay begins with the story of, and the correct option is option A, an old woman. Question number 35. The Pleasure of Ignorance is a humorous essay, sad essay, horror story, detective story. And the correct option is option A, humorous essay. Question number 36. In The Pleasure of Ignorance, the writer mentioned that thousands of people die without knowing the difference between, and the correct option is option D, beech and elm trees. Question number 37. What do we get out of ignorance? And the correct option is option A, pleasure. Question number 38. Who famed for wisdom according to Robert Lane? And the correct answer is option C, Socrates. Question number 39. What is the meaning of capricious? And the correct answer is option B, unpredicted. Question number 40. Who could not distinguish between thrush and blackbird? And the correct answer is option A, modern city man. Question number 41. Who is the writer of The Selfish Giant? And the correct answer is option A, Oscar Wilde. Question number 42. The story The Selfish Giant is taken from? And the correct option is option B, The Happy Prince and Other Stories. Question number 43. Who visited the garden in the form of a little child? And the correct answer is option D, Jesus Christ. Question number 44. How many peach trees were there in the garden? And the correct answer is option A, 12. Question number 45. Who hang the board, trespassers will be prosecuted? And the correct answer is option B, the giant. Question number 46. In the story, The Selfish Giant changes into a, and the correct option is option C, good person. Question number 47. Which seasons are mentioned in The Selfish Giant? And the correct answer is option D, both A and B, that means winter and spring seasons are mentioned in The Selfish Giant. Question number 48. The giant's body was covered with, and the options are white flowers, snow, hailstones, leaves. And the correct answer is option A, white flowers. Question number 49. What is the moral of the story The Selfish Giant? And the options are love, forgiveness, selfishness, both A and B. And the correct answer is option D, both A and B, love and forgiveness. Question number 50. Where did the children find the dead giant? And the options are under the tree, in the house, on the roof, near the sea. And the correct answer is option A, under the tree. Question number 51. The diamond necklace is a short story, poem, drama, letter. And the correct answer is option A, short story. Question number 52. Who is the heroine of the story, The Diamond Necklace? And the correct answer is option C, Mathilde. Question number 53. How do you describe Mathilde? And the options are charming, ambitious, greedy, all of these. And the correct answer is option D, all of these. Question number 54. Who is Mathilde's husband? And the correct option is option C, Mr. Loisel. Question number 55. What was the cost of Madame Forestier's necklace? And the correct answer is option A, 5,000 francs. Question number 56. How much money did Mathilde pay for the new necklace? And the correct option is option D, 36,000 francs. Question number 57. Why did Mathilde give a new necklace to Madame Frostier? And the correct option is option C, because Mathilde lost her necklace. Question number 58. What is the name of a middle class couple in the story? And the correct option is option A, Mathilde and Mr. Loisel. Question number 59. Who does not like Adam Smith's philosophy? And the correct answer is option A, G.B. Shaw. Question number 60. To whom Shaw called a far-sighted economist? And the correct option is option A, Goldsmith's.